Hello everyone, my name is Nama Rashid and I'm going to talk about design thinking today. I have been reading and working practically on design thinking a lot lately. So with this video, I hope to get a chance to share my understanding about design thinking with you. I will begin with the definition of design thinking, its key elements, the processes of design thinking, and talk about the context in which design thinking is useful. And end the presentation with the value of design thinking to entrepreneurs. So design thinking in its simple terms is a human-centric approach for problem solving by creating new ideas. It is based heavily on the methods and processes that designers use, but it doesn't necessarily have to be very design specific. And design thinking can be applied to any fields. So there are four key elements of design thinking, which is user-centered, highly creative, hands-on, iterative. So we need to understand the users for which we are creating the product, as well as it needs to be creative and playful. So when we are looking at a product, we have to look at it from different perspectives and consider a variety of solutions. Also, design thinking tells us to be hands-on and collaborative, which means people with diverse perspectives work together in a flat hierarchy. So having multidisciplinary teams working collaboratively usually encourage different viewpoints and co-creation. Design thinking also tells us to be iterative. So once you have come up with a solution or product, it's very important that you keep challenging yourself and reframing your problem. So you have to keep testing, iterating, and testing again before you finally think that your solution is the best for your users. So early rounds of testing and feedback helps to ensure that you are delivering the solutions that people want. So in this slide, we are seeing that when can design thinking be useful? Design thinking can be useful when we are creating innovation by combining the right people, the needed space, and a supporting process. So since you're seeing this Venn diagram, you're seeing that it shows how cross-functional thinking is. And the only way to reach true innovation is making sure that your desirability, feasibility, and viability connects. So the desirability of your solution is creating something which fits to your users' needs. The feasibility of your solution is about whether or not you are able to implement your solution in an effective manner. The third one, viability, is we also need to have a business model for your solution, because without it, we will not be able to earn money and the business or your idea is not going to sustain in the long run. So these three features are explained in this Venn diagram, and we have to make sure that we are in the intersection between the desirability, viability, and feasibility to make design thinking useful. So we can see the five steps of innovation. This is basically the five steps of design thinking. So far, we have learned that design thinking is a non-linear iterative process which seeks to understand users, the challenging assumptions, redefining problems, and creating innovative solutions to prototype and test. So the five steps of design thinking process are mainly empathy, define, ideate, prototype, and test, which I shall explain briefly now. So the first stage of the design thinking process is empathy, which is observing and engaging with people in order to understand them on a physiological and emotional level. Most time is spent in this stage by getting to know your users and understanding what they want, their needs, and their objectives. During this phase, the designer seeks to set aside their assumptions and gather real insights about the user. The next stage is define, which is the second stage is defined, which is basically defining the problem. In this phase of design thinking, we are going to focus on becoming aware of people's needs and develop insights from the data we have gathered in the empathy stage. We will think about what difficulties and barriers are our users coming up against, what patterns have we observed in the empathy stage, and what is the big user problem that our team needs to solve. So it is basically the wicked problem. By the end of the define phase, we will have a clear problem statement. And the key in this stage is to frame the problem in a user-centric way. The next stage is ideate. Ideation is a critical component of design thinking. With a solid understanding of our users and a clear problem statement in mind, it's time to start working on potential solutions. In this stage, we are going to brainstorm a number of ideas and suspend any judgment. So no idea is going to be rejected. So your idea might be too far-fetched, but it isn't a problem. We are ideating in order to transition from ideation stage to creating solutions for our users in this process. Ideation is our chance to combine our understanding of the problems to generate solutions and that we have for our users in mind. Particularly early in this design project, ideation is about pushing a widest possible range of ideas from which we can select the best solution for our users. The next stage is prototyping stage, which is a roughly and rapid portion of the design process. In this stage, we mostly create a low fidelity prototype in the form of a sketch to convey our ideas quickly. We are also going to put its solution to test and highlight any constraints and flaws. Throughout the prototype stage, the process, the proposed solution may be accepted. It can be improved, redesigned, or rejected depending on how they get along in the prototype form. The next stage is testing, which is a very crucial step in the design thinking process. It is a part of an iterative process that provides us with feedback. The purpose of testing is to learn what works and what doesn't work, and then iterate. This means going back to your prototype and modifying it based on feedback. The design thinking process is a non-linear but flexible process. With every new discovery in this prototype and testing stage, we will need to rethink and redefine what we have done before and keep working in a loop to make the solution best for our users. Now that we have known what is design thinking, let's talk about what is how it is going to benefit entrepreneurs. So the process of design thinking as a strategy of innovation puts together creative and logical thinking with experimentation in order to achieve the perfect product for the end users. Entrepreneurs can use design thinking to generate bold ideas and creating a final product that satisfies needs of the users. They can find inspiration to create a solution by observing users in their own environment through identifying their latent needs, and they can also test assumption of their new ideas and continuously shape them into viable opportunities. Teaching entrepreneurs through a design lens can help entrepreneurs identify and act on unique venture opportunities using toolkit of observation, fieldwork, and understanding value creation across multiple stakeholder groups. With this design thinking video, I hope I have been able to touch every aspect of design thinking shortly, but if you have any questions or feedback on this lesson, you can reach me at my email given here. Thank you for being with me all this time.